In the town of Dois Riachos, everyone knows Tota, Marta da Silva's first coach.
Here, from the moment they're born, they play football.
He immediately detected Marta's extraordinary talent.
Marta.
Today, he shares his pride with Marta's mother. Though reluctant at first, Teresa ended up accepting her daughter's passion.
She'd leave the house saying that she was going to school, but she wouldn't go.
She secretly went to play football.
Yeah, she'd hide for 2 or 3 days.
Born into poverty, Marta played here on a dry riverbed, always with the boys. They included Thiago Nunes. He remembers the humiliations she suffered in competitions.
A fan once asked her to take off her clothes to see if she was really a woman. We were all uncomfortable. We welcomed her because we needed her. She was different, one of the best players we had, and there was no boys with her skills. We just wanted Marta on our side.
The best player in the world today has given women's football a global face. We got to meet Marta a few weeks ago on her visit to Brazil.
I had to suffer all of this so that we could use it as an example. It's not your gender that should define the way you work, it's what you produce, and if you do it with excellence.
In her home state, girls aim to follow Marta's path. Her career and her level of play inspire these young players of Maceió's women's team.
She's not the type of player that does tricks with the ball. She takes the ball and charges forward towards the goal to do what she does best. Run fast, shoot, and score.
All they hope for is that in July, Marta can bring Brazil the Women's World Cup Championship, the only title that still resists her.